I'm currently working on the connection between odors and emotions, and more particularly in how our perception of odors, so the sense of smell, may be altered during depressive states. If I ask you to bring in mind one odor, like the smell of coffee in the morning, you will might immediately feel how this feels nice. So odors are powerful elicitors of emotions, and they do so by activating the same brain areas that are activated during an emotional perception or emotional feeling. The idea of my research is if these brain areas are functioning in a different way, so malfunctioning, like in a disorder, for example, a mood disorder, depression or bipolar disorder, will this influence in our way of perceived smells? Depression causes disability in up to 20% of world population and is a very recurrent disorder. The tools we have today to fight it are limited in terms of efficacy, and some of them have several side effects. So maybe if we can manage to kind of prevent it or see it, identify it in the very beginning or the very beginning of the second episode or third episode when it arrives, we can act more quickly and define it and see it in the person. I'm still in the very beginning of it, and acquiring data from a health population for the moment. Even in health populations, we have a big variability of emotional states. So I'm trying to see if there's some correlations between the emotional state of a person and his traits of personality. I'm doing both explicit measurements, so I give people some odors to smell and I ask them, how did you like that? How intense do you find it? And how familiar you are with this odor, because there are these three dimensions in odors. It's not only if you like it or not, maybe when you are very familiar with an odor, you tend to like it more, for example, what reminds you of something, and the intensity that we don't perceive all in the same way and might show our threshold of perception. So I ask them explicitly, and I also deliver odors while they are in the scanner, lying in the MRI, so magnetic resonance imaging. It's a way to take photos of the brain every 2 seconds, very quickly, and we're doing the functional MRI, so we can take photos of the activity of their brain while they're smelling an odor. Okay. And just after, they tell us if they liked it or not and how do they find it. Maybe that's a bit arrogant, but I thought that I'm getting bored very easily, so I need a work that keeps me searching, looking for something, changing, modifying, something exciting, and always in the movement of, oh, something new, oh, this we didn't know, oh, how did this work? And so that's why I personally wanted to work in research. And for reasons of curiosity, of course, I had a lot of questions. How does nature work? How do humans work as well? Because we're also different, but so very same, finally. And the particular topic, so I did my PhD on depression, and I was not working with humans. I was working mostly on animal models, and I was doing some more molecular biology in order to identify, can we find a new treatment for depression? And then I thought, okay, maybe I can change a bit my approach, because I think that humans tend to be more depressed than animals. So I say, let's see how we can see it. How can approach the same question from a human perspective? And now I would like to do both. So because both ways of researching gives you different data and give different information, and maybe if we combine these two and put people from these different fields talk together, we will be even more like efficient and more able to understand in depth what exactly is going on.